Welcome all of you to our channel. Thank you for watching.
Should I divorce my extremely frustrating husband? I've been with my husband for 15 years. We dated largely happily, certainly comfortably for 7 years. I had complaints. Sure, who doesn't? But what we had together worked on so many other levels. The things were, he really got me. And as you might remember, there weren't all that many Dukes and sunny California in the early 2000s who were eager to sign up for a relationship with a self-defined neurotic with unresolved abandonment issues, intellectual pretension, and very little in the way of real-world skills. When we met, I was 27 and attempt and deeply unrealized. Then I met George, not his real name. George was a lot like me, clever, hyperbole, into all the right cultural touchstones, unafraid to hold an unpopular opinion, a friendly contrarian. I liked him immediately, and he somehow escaped friend zoning, which was my usual defense against guys I liked. He was my first real relationship, the first person I lived with. And with his help, I eventually pulled myself out of my extended adolescence, applied to grad school in New York, and became the writer I already was in my head. We spent 3 years in New York living up his savings while I learned how to be a journalist and quickly discovered that this career choice was not nearly as pragmatic as I'd imagined. But it was awesome. We ate at great restaurants, went to endless museums, hung out with our friends on Manhattan rooftops until the only ones left on the road were cabs, saw tons of movies, and explored our art. While I was busy getting my first bylines, he explored a new career in the art and got very, very good at it, had a couple of group shows at small spots, and quickly developed delusion of grandeur. Obviously, being in a creative field myself, I know how this goes and suffer from my own grand misapprehensions about my talent, so I never really challenged him on it. Then I turned 34, and I will let you guess what happened. Yes, my biological clock went into overdrive. We had talks about kids here and there, and he always like, someday, staring down the barrel of my mid-30s, I realized I would have depressed the issue. After speaking to him reasonably, didn't produce any momentum, I finally delivered an ultimatum. Get me pregnant or let me go. So we got pregnant. He seemed happy, was happy. I think our daughter was born in the spring of 2009, and suddenly the whole universe realigned itself so that she was at its center and I was an orbiting planet. It was a relief to focus on someone else for a change. The tricky part was that the baby never slept. Like seriously, for the whole first year, and this did exactly the kind of psychic damage you expect. We were constantly deprived of time to ourselves. I compensate by overgiving and he basically checks out. Not because he's horrible person, but because we were in a state of crisis. Because in addition to the whole sleeping thing, almost as soon as she was born, we ran out of money. I could give you a whole long explanation of how this happened, but it would just be a justification. The truth of the matter is that neither of us are good planners. We've both been overly optimistic about our career prospects, and we vastly underestimated the expense of having a kid. The joke was seriously on us.
Thank you for watching our video. Don't forget to like, share video, and leave your comments below. See you guys on the next episode.